So whenever you are looking at creating a campaign, you want to name it properly. You want to choose the networks that you're going to go onto. Do you want to go onto Google? Do you want to go onto the search partners? Do you want to put this onto Bing, Yahoo, whatever it's going to be? You need to consider your bid. I said earlier on, whenever you use the keyword tool, Google will suggest bids to you and very much take them with a pinch of salt. What I would say to everybody is within, if we use your RentPro stuff again, if you don't mind, I'm quite sure that you make an average, there's an average sale in there somewhere. Probably varies to a degree, but there's an average sale. What I would be looking at is saying, right, what is our average sale worth and how much am I willing to sacrifice to get that sale? What everybody else does is they start up at the other end and go, what should I pay? Why not? And then by the time they've sold something, they've realized they've maybe lost money or they're not selling anything because they're not bidding enough and it all goes to hell. So by bidding, you need to consider, right, what is my product? What do I make from it? What am I willing to sacrifice? How many clicks can I get for that sacrifice? Divide the sacrifice by the clicks to give you a bid. Pretty simple. If I talked slower, it would be even more simple. But this isn't an idea that you just go to Google and let them tell you. Google don't understand your business. They don't understand your budget. They don't understand your margins, but they do understand how to get money out of you. So you need to really consider that. When it comes to budget, every single day we get asked by people, what should we spend? It's brilliant. Would you ever walk into a car sales place and say, I'd like a new car, what's your budget? Oh, you tell me, that's fine. You wouldn't do it. Why would you ask somebody that you're going to spend your money with what your budget is? Doing this stuff should be part of a bigger marketing plan. It all affects itself. If you're doing above the line stuff, it should all be coming out of a budget, an amount that you're prepared to spend and you have set aside, not that you're kind of scrambling for at the end. And location, you need to localize your campaigns. Give people what they want. We do a campaign for a really big printing company that competes with the likes of Vistaprint and Moo and all those sort of people. We have campaigns that if somebody types in Business Cards London, there's an ad comes up Business Cards London. Business Cards Cardiff, Business Cards Cardiff. You can even do it down to the degree of having a local phone number in every single ad. You don't even have to be there. But you can localize all of these ads to make people feel that you actually are in the geography that they're looking for. And quite simply, you'll see down here, for example, just an idea that you can target Ireland. It'll tell you there's, what, nearly 5.5 million people. It actually tells you, well, that's actually devices. So in Northern Ireland at the minute, there's 1.8 million devices available. There's only, what, 1.6, 1.7 million people, something like that. So it gives you an idea out there. You can pick your market and say, right, Belfast, there's X amount of people. We'll go after that. But look at Craigavon. It also does this. And then Ballymena, and then over here. But we're not going to go for Mahara because there's not as many people looking for what we want in that area. So you can tailor all these things. Instead of trying to be everywhere, be where your client actually is looking for you. And then I'm not really going to spend any time in this, but these are what the ads look like. Just try to make them relevant, make them stand out, and include a call to action. Tell people what you want them to do. Buy online now, call now, make an appointment, inquire, whatever you want to do. You need to tell people. I would be of the opinion that all of our IQs drop by at least 50% when we go onto the internet. We see exactly what people are typing in to make ads appear, and it's embarrassing. We can't spell. We can't do anything when we go onto the internet. So you need to tell people what they're going to do.